Assalamu alaikum, everyone. This is Sumayya Khalifa with the Islamic Speakers Bureau of Atlanta, welcoming you to another amazing day of our Ramadan reflections. And we are so honored and happy and excited to be hearing today from our own Ustaza Zainab Ansari. And Zainab, welcome. Happy day to you and a blessed Ramadan day. And we look forward to hearing your reflections, inshallah.
Thank you so much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala barakatuh. Thank you, dear Sister Sumayya. I pray that you had a wonderful weekend and a happy Mother's Day. So happy to see everybody this morning. So this is Monday, May 11, and we are already on the 18th day of Ramadan. So it's really amazing how quickly time is flying by. And I pray that that time has been very productive and very blessed for all of you. Now, I wanted to return to a beautiful verse from the Quran that I shared with all of you at the beginning of our series of inspirations. So I'm going to just go ahead and share my screen with you so you can see the ayah to which I'm referring. And then let's go ahead and take a look at it at the slideshow feature. So, you know, if you recall, I mentioned that if we kind of go through the course of our day and think about the number of times that we actually invoke the attributes of God, Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim, or the merciful and mercy giving, that we invoke those names upward of 50 or even 60 times a day. And I actually decided that I would continue to focus on those names, with also bringing in a reminder of the forgiveness of God for the duration of this series, just because there's just so much to unpack here, right? So we know that scholars have said that there are up to 99 names or attributes of God. So of course, we could definitely take a lot more time to focus on the others. But again, each one is so rich and so layered in meaning, there is just so much to unpack. So I really wanted to come back to the ones that we actually began with. So by way of reminder, if you have your Quran in front of you, if you look at chapter 17, Al-Isra, verse 110, you see, for example, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, say, invoke Allah, invoke God, or invoke the most gracious, right? Awud ar-Rahman. By whatever name you invoke, to Allah, to Him belong the most beautiful names, right? Falahu al-Asma'ul Husna. And then this ayah goes on to say, and do not be loud in your prayers or don't be silent therein, but seek between that a way. So a reminder to embrace that way of balance, right? Even when it comes to our Quranic recitation itself. So this is one ayah that I want you all to have. And then make sure that if you want a sort of a specific mention of these names, Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim, as they actually appear in the Quranic text outside of the opening, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, or the opening invocation of God's names, then that open the chapters, then you have this beautiful verse. This is chapter 59. I'm sorry, I didn't put the citation. It's chapter 59, verse 22, right? Hu Allahu alladhi la ilaha illahu alimul ghaybi wa shahada. Who are Rahman al-Rahim. He is God, the one who there is no deity but He, the all-knower of the unseen and the witnessed. He is the most gracious, the most merciful. So when I was reading these verses of the Quran, I was reflecting upon the fact that, first of all, there are so many beautiful names. Again, very rich in meaning. And as I mentioned earlier, divided largely into names of grandeur, jalal, and power, and also names of jamal, or beauty, and how there's such a balance between all of these names. And when you bring all of the names together, right, the main reason why God reminds us of these attributes in the Quran is as a way of reassuring, right, us as human beings in a world that is increasingly sort of unpredictable, right? A world that can often be sort of beset by worries and anxieties. This is a reminder that God the Exalted is characterized by every single attribute of perfection. And for me, this is a deeply reassuring thing, right? As we look at, again, the world around us, as we are reminded, sometimes really on a day-to-day basis, of the frailties of the human being, right? What a beautiful reminder that Allah Ta'ala, God who is exalted, is again characterized by every attribute of beauty and perfection. And, you know, one of the things that we should remind ourselves of is that when we witness, when we see certain attributes in human beings that we admire, whether we see a mother who is especially tender or compassionate, or a father who is especially protective and caring, right? Or we see acts of amazing kind of self-sacrifice or generosity amongst human beings, especially in the month of Ramadan, that these attributes, these qualities, these traits that we admire in each other, that these are just a fraction, right? Even the language really escapes me, but this is just a fraction of the attributes of perfection that belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, God the Exalted, that He's bequeathed to human beings just a very small portion of these attributes, again, to remind us that, as the Quran tells us, that there is nothing like unto Him. And again, this is something deeply reassuring for me personally, right? As I think about the fact that sometimes we don't necessarily know, right, how the next month will look or the next 6 months, right? That there is a certain, this experience of kind of being indoors like this has really meant that time has both kind of like, has really both slowed down and sped up really in unusual ways. But in the midst of all of that, to be able to contemplate and reflect for a moment on the transcendence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's a way of connecting us to something that is really, that is permanent, something that is just way beyond that which we can really kind of conceptualize as human beings. So I actually find that, you know, it actually helps me to appreciate more the place of human beings in this cosmos, reflecting on the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then another thing too, as we reflect on the mercy and the forgiveness of which we want to avail ourselves, you know, this being the 18th day of Ramadan, we are still in that portion of forgiveness, that second portion of Ramadan, passing into that last phase of Ramadan, which is the days of seeking salvation. But as we are still in those days of forgiveness, as we think about God's attributes of Rahman and Rahim and Ghafur and Ghafar and Wadud and Halim, loving and forbearing and forgiving and accepting repentance and merciful and compassionate and all these things that we invoke God by, that it's very important for us to understand that these are the days where we want to ask for an increased level of awareness of those very human frailties that I'm discussing. Why? Because it's when we are have greater sort of perception of these frailties that I think we're really able to grow, right? It's by acknowledging our humanity in its full kind of spectrum, right? Of all those different qualities that God has given us, I think that we are able to fully more appreciate our humanity, as well as become more committed servants and devotees of God the Exalted. So we are in those days of forgiveness still. And I really want to encourage all of us, right, to ask God to give us this gift of perception, to where we are able to hold up that mirror, right? To that mirror of Ramadan, that mirror has now become increasingly polished and it is clear. And to ask God to afford us the gift of holding that mirror up in front of us so that we can see ourselves again in that full spectrum of humanity and to see the things that we want to work on, right? Because that will be a means of growth. And to ask ourselves, what is the important spiritual work that we need to do to move forward, right? What do we want this Ramadan to really show us? Because again, we've been given a unique opportunity to experience a Ramadan unlike any other. And surely in that, there are lessons for all of us. And ultimately, as we think about ourselves as human beings and how we fit into the larger plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to ask that question, to ask Allah ta'ala, how do we fit into this grand scheme of things? What is our purpose? We've been given, again, a unique opportunity to think about all of that. So I want to leave you with this dua right here. This is a really nice dua or supplication, you can say, during this time. What's so interesting is that the reason why the Prophet, peace be upon him, made this supplication was because he said, this is a hadith I think you can find in the collection of Imam Muslim, that Ar-Rahman, and it's interesting that in this hadith, the Prophet, peace be upon him, actually invokes this particular name of God, Ar-Rahman, that it is the one who is compassionate to all, whose rahmah encompasses all of us, right? All human beings. It is that the hearts of humanity, right, are held between or are encompassed by the two fingers of the Ar-Rahman, right? Obviously using that language more figuratively, but the hearts of all human beings are grasped between the two fingers of Ar-Rahman, and he directs those hearts, he turns those hearts in the direction that he wills. So it was really, this is the context for why the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, Ya muqallib al-qulubi, thabbit qalbi ala deenik, right? Ya muqallib al-qulub, O turner of hearts, thabbit qalbi, right? Fix my heart, or our hearts, make our hearts firm, thabbit, really, this is what it means, right? It means make our hearts firm upon your religion and upon your obedience. And after all, this is what we seek in the month of Ramadan, right? Again, stability in the midst of things that have become so unpredictable. Again, connecting ourselves to that which is permanent and that which never, ever passes. So thank you so much. I was happy to share this reflection with you all, and make sure you tune in for the rest of our series, inshallah ta'ala. Good seeing everybody. Take care. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
Ustazah Zainab, thank you so much. What a beautiful reminders for all of us about the importance of Ramadan. And I love that polished mirror where we can look at ourselves and see how we could grow and what we could do differently. Thank you so much for also reminding us of the majesty of Allah, God, the Almighty, and how we fit in the grand scheme of things, and also how this specific Ramadan is a very special and unique one, and we must take advantage of every second and every minute of it. Again, thank you so much for your beautiful words, for your reflections, and for purifying our heart and making them more tender and ready to have another great day of Ramadan. Jazakallah khair. Thank you very much. And greetings to all of you. Please like our YouTube channel. And please, if you like the work of the ISB, please support us financially at isbatlanta.org. No amount is too small or too large. We appreciate you. Thank you. And assalamu alaikum. And we'll see you in the next opportunity for the Ramadan reflections. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.